We're not happy here, folks. To settle for this earth, to be content in a strange land. Take a fish, put him on the beach. He's not happy. He's not happy. So what's it going to take to make him happy? Do you cover him with a mountain of cash? Do you bring him a beach chair and some sunglasses? Do you go out and buy him a copy of Playfish magazine and a martini? No, you know what makes him happy. And that is you put him back in his element. You put him back in the water. He'll never be happy on the beach simply because he was not made for the beach. And friend, you'll never be completely happy on earth. You won't be, simply because you were not made for earth. Now, we're going to have our moments, the newborn on the breast, the bride on the arm, the sunshine on our back. But even these moments, even these good moments, are slivers of light compared to the great joy in the sunrise that awaits us. Isn't this the concluding promise of David? He said, "And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Forever house is the house of the Lord. This house is not our forever house. This is just short-term housing. This is not our home. The scripture says our homeland is where? It's in heaven. It's not here. Our homeland is in heaven. God has set eternity in the hearts of men. There is something inside of you that is longing for an eternal home. Down deep, you know this is not your home. So be careful not to act like you are. Don't lower the duffel bag too soon. Would you hang up pictures on the wall of a Greyhound bus? Would you ever load a king-size bed on a commercial flight? No. You know, it's simply a tool of transportation to get you to your home. And that's what this life is. It's simply a mode of transportation to make sure we get home safely. Don't treat this world like it's home. It isn't. We're going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever.